Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surbhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Friday, the 17th of April. Group of ministers meet to review coronavirus situation in India. Afghan government extends Kabul lockdown as COVID-19 fears grow. And Sri Lankan government starts new food supply chain after shutting markets. And now for all the details. A group of ministers meeting on Friday reviewed preparedness and actions for COVID-19 management in India as the cases tally crossed the 13,000 mark. Meanwhile, the Reserve Bank of India announced a reduction in reverse repo rate and liquidity support for financial institutions to support the economy amid the lockdown.
As India battles a sudden surge in coronavirus cases, a group of ministers on Friday held a detailed review of the situation arising out of the outbreak in the country. The meeting, chaired by India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan, discussed the current status, preparedness and actions for management of COVID-19. The number of coronavirus cases in India crossed the 13,000 mark, with at least 437 deaths reported till Friday afternoon. India had on April 14 extended nationwide lockdown until May 3rd. As the number of coronavirus cases went past 10,000, despite a three-week shutdown announced last month. Health Ministry officials, however, said there has been a 40% decline in average growth factor, even as the country has increased COVID-19 testing.
कि लॉकडाउन से पहले अगर हमारे देश का डबलिंग रेट ऑफ केसेस लगभग 3 दिन था, तो पिछले 7 दिनों को अगर डेटा देखते हैं तो हमारा डबलिंग रेट अब 6.2 डेज है। और मैं आप लोगों की दृष्टि में लाना चाहूंगा कि 19 स्टेट्स और यूनियन टेरिटरीज ऐसे हैं जहां पर की डबलिंग रेट देश के एवरेज से भी कम है।
Meanwhile, the Reserve Bank of India or RBI on Friday unveiled a slew of measures which included a reduction in reverse repo rate and liquidity support for financial institutions among others to support the economy. The central bank said that the country is expected to post a sharp turnaround in 2021-22 and also announced Rs 50,000 crore booster package for small and medium-sized industries to recover from the ongoing lockdown.
4 terrorists were neutralized by security forces in 2 separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Friday. Cordon and search operations were still underway till the last reports came in. Security forces neutralized 4 terrorists in 2 separate encounters in Shopian and Kishtwar districts in India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. The encounters broke out after cordon and search operations were launched in both the areas upon specific inputs about the presence of terrorists. In the ensuing gunfight, the terrorists were gunned down. The identity and the group affiliation of the slain terrorists were being ascertained while search operations were still underway till the last reports came in. India has long blamed neighbouring Pakistan of arming and infiltrating terrorists across the border to mount attacks on Indian soil. Pakistan, however, denies the allegations. Moving on, the International Monetary Fund on Thursday approved nearly $1.4 billion in emergency financing to Pakistan to meet a balance of payments needed stemming from the novel coronavirus pandemic.
The International Monetary Fund on Thursday said its executive board had approved $1.386 billion in emergency financing to Pakistan to meet balance of payments needed stemming from the novel coronavirus pandemic. IMF First Deputy Managing Director Geoffrey Okamoto said expeditious donor support was needed to close the remaining balance of payments gap and ease the adjustment burden. Pakistan has recorded over 7,000 cases of coronavirus and more than 130 deaths. But experts have expressed fears that the country of 215 million people could see a rapid and devastating increase due to its shortage of medical infrastructure and crowded cities. The IMF said the funds to come from its rapid financing instrument will help Pakistan deal with a decline in international reserves and allow it to fund targeted and temporary spending increases aimed at containing the pandemic and mitigating its economic impact.
Afghanistan has also extended its ongoing Kabul lockdown for 3 more weeks, vowing more restrictions on movement in the city, which has an estimated population of 6 million. The decision comes as over 800 COVID-19 cases have been confirmed across the country.
The Afghan government on Thursday extended the Kabul lockdown for 3 more weeks, vowing more restrictions on movement in the city, which has an estimated population of 6 million. The lockdown also implies to provincial districts. Meanwhile, roads that connect Kabul with other provinces will also remain closed. Presidential spokesman Sadiq Siddiqui in a tweet announced that government employees except essential service employees will be on off for 3 more weeks until May 9. The outbreak comes as Afghan health facilities are faced with a lack of testing kits, personal protection equipment, trained personnel and funds to conduct an adequate number of tests to slow the spread of coronavirus. The main COVID-19 testing center in Kabul, the Afghan-Japan hospital, has stopped taking new samples for the past 2 days due to an overload of tests. So far, 840 cases have been reported in total, 30 people have died of the virus and 54 have recovered across Afghanistan.
The NATO has reiterated support to Afghan forces, saying the alliance is in support of the US-Taliban agreement, but adjusting the troop levels in Afghanistan is still conditions-based.
NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg has yet again expressed support to Afghan forces, saying the alliance is in support of the US-Taliban agreement, but adjusting the troop levels in Afghanistan is conditions-based. Speaking about the target troop level of 12,000, Stoltenberg said, "We were actually almost at the level until mid-2017. Then we had an increase of 16,000. Now we are back again almost at the same level we had before the increase in 2017. Stoltenberg also reiterated his call to the Taliban to work towards peace and asked them to sit down and engage in intra-Afghan negotiations.
We actually believe that the best way we can support the peace efforts is to continue to support the Afghan security forces by doing that, sending a message to Taliban that they will not win on the battlefield. They have to sit down and make real compromises on the negotiating table."
In the US-Taliban agreement signed in February, one of the main clauses is that United States will reduce its numbers of troops in country from roughly 12,000 to 8,600 within 135 days. The Taliban in return guaranteed that Afghanistan will not become a safe haven for terrorists again.
Sri Lanka's Civil Defense Force is buying produce directly from farmers and distributing it across the island nation to help farmers who have been hit hard due to coronavirus lockdown.
Sri Lanka's Civil Defense Force is buying produce directly from farmers and distributing it across the island to help farmers who have been hit hard by measures to curb the spread of coronavirus. Farmers have struggled to sell their harvest amid a 24-hour lockdown in 6 districts considered hotspots, closing markets and stopping the sale of goods. A curfew is also in place in other districts but lifts every third day for 10 hours. Thousands of soldiers, vehicles and public servants have been deployed in the government purchasing effort, which will involve distributing produce to households and shops.
ඒ මගින් ඒ ජාතික ව්‍යසනයට මුහුණ දෙන වගේම ගොවියා ගොවියා වෙනුවෙන් හැදියත් වෙලා ගොවියාගේ ජීවිතේ ගැට ගහ ගන්න තියෙන මේ කුසි නිෂ්පාදන අලෙවි කර ගැනීමට අවස්ථාව ලබා දීම ගැන අපි මෙහෙමින් ස්තුතිවන්ත වෙනවා.
It was a similar scene in Anuradhapura in Sri Lanka's North Central Province on Thursday, with pumpkin trucks seen queuing in the streets. The produce was loaded into military and civilian trucks headed for capital Colombo to be distributed to low-income groups.
මේ දවස්වල මේ අපේ ගොවිතැන් කරලා වට්ටක් කටික විකුණ ගන්න බැරුව අපි ගොඩක් දුක් කරගතායෙන් තමයි පසු වුණේ
Sri Lanka has reported over 235 cases of coronavirus and 7 deaths so far.
At a time when a nationwide lockdown is in place and the threat of COVID-19 looms large, a couple tied the knot wearing masks and gloves in a simple ceremony in India's Surat city. The marriage was solemnized with just 6 people in attendance.
An Indian couple, Dishan Punamia and Pooja Barnota, got married on Thursday while wearing masks, gloves and sanitized their hands as they tied the nuptial knot amid the ongoing COVID-19 lockdown. The pair, like every other couple, wished to celebrate their big day with a grand ceremony in front of hundreds of guests, but the deadly coronavirus forced the change in plan. The bride and the groom performed the ceremony on the terrace of their building with all Hindu rituals.
अचानक ही ये जो महामारी कोविड-19 जो आया भारत देश के अंदर उसके कारण हमने हमारी शादी कैंसिल कर दी थी बट हमारे घर के बुजुर्ग ने बोला कि अपन 4-5 जन मिल के शादी ये फिनिश कर लेते क्योंकि ये जो मुहूर्त होता है अपन भारतीय संस्कृति के हिसाब से वो मुहूर्त में शादी कर ही देते थे इसके कारण से हम लोग ने 4-6 जन मिल के ये शादी का संपन्न करने का एक आश्चर्य लिया था
जैसे कि ध्यान रखना चाहिए था कि सैनिटाइजिंग का ग्लव्स का और मास्क का हमने ध्यान रखते हुए सब काम किया
The coronavirus lockdown in India was originally scheduled to end on April 14, but it has now been extended till May 3rd, keeping in mind the rising number of cases. The move has postponed or even cancelled many weddings across the country.
Wholesale traders of groceries in Indian capital New Delhi are turning back time by using traditional bullock carts in place of regular carrier vehicles to supply essentials to smaller shops amid the nationwide lockdown.
Wholesale traders of groceries in Indian capital New Delhi are using bullock carts in place of regular carrier vehicles to supply essentials to smaller shops during the lockdown imposed to stem the spread of coronavirus. India imposed a nationwide lockdown late last month to limit the outbreak, suspending all air, rail and road transport. However, even after getting the supply, traders were finding it difficult to move the goods around the city due to the lockdown. Traders then turned to bullock carts and hand carts to deliver the goods.
हमारे को रोटी वोटी मिल जाती है थोड़ा पहले से थोड़ा बेहतर काम हो रहा है और कुछ पॉजिट जो लॉकडाउन में लोग बाग बांट रहे हैं पिट रहे हैं उनके लिए सामान पहुंचा रहे हैं थोड़ा उनसे लोगों को राशन मिल रहा है कुछ खाने पीने की सुविधा हो रही है हमें भी जानवर को भी कुछ खाने पीने के हमें भी खाने पीने के लिए मिल जाता है भाजी
ट्रेडिशनल बुलेट कार्ट्स इन द मार्केट गेट लोडेड विद ग्रेन्स पल्सेस ऑयल वेजिटेबल्स एंड अदर फूड आइटम्स एंड मेक देयर वे टू नियर बाय एरियाज
दूसरे शहरों में पास के गलियों में जाकर के बैलगाड़ियों के थ्रू सप्लाई किया जा रहा है सामान को मगर बराबर आदमी को राशन पानी मिल रहा है राशन पानी चावल है दाल है तेल है सब्जियां हैं 3 घंटे में आदमी बहुत कुछ कर लेता है
The country extended its 21-day lockdown which ended on April 14 up to May 3rd after the cases of coronavirus rose steadily. Government has allowed some essential services to function but has strictly advised people against stepping out.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Group of ministers meet to review coronavirus situation in India. Afghan government extends Kabul lockdown as COVID-19 fears grow. And Sri Lankan government starts new food supply chain after shutting markets. Now viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline. And follow us on Twitter at @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend and good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.